Today's topic is the different system of the engine, that is the fuel supply system, cooling system, lubrication system, and air cleaning system. So these are the different system of IC engine: fuel supply system, cooling system, lubrication system, and air cleaner. So what do you mean by the cooling system? It is a system which control the engine temperature and is known as the cooling system. Okay. The system which control the engine temperature is known as the cooling system. Okay. And necessity of the why engine required the cooling system, you can see here in IC engine at the time of the power stroke, near about 2000 degrees Celsius temperature we are increase in combustion chamber. You can see why the necessity: the temperature of the burning gases in the cylinder reaches up to 1500 degrees Celsius to 2000 degrees Celsius, which result in expansion, wear and tear of the cylinder. Because cylinder is made from the steel, so it's the boiling point is near about 1700 degrees Celsius. So due to very high temperature, the film of lubricating oil get oxidized, and this will result in piston deterioration. And large temperature difference may result in a distortion of the engine component, and higher temperature also lower the volumetric efficiency of the engine. For satisfactory performance of the engine, it should neither be covered or nor overcooked. And experiment have shown that the petrol engine operate best of 180 degree Fahrenheit engine at the 200 degree Fahrenheit, and diesel engine at 140 degree Fahrenheit to 162 degree Fahrenheit. So what is the method of the cooling? There are two type of cooling. One is the air cooling and other is the water cooling. So you can see a diagram of the cooling fins between the valves here. It is the types of the air cooling system you can see in a motorcycle. Okay, the air cooled engines are those engines in which heat is conducted from the working component of the engine to the atmosphere directly. And in such engines, cylinders are generally not grouped in a block. So you can see here it is the cylinder, or we can see the combustion chamber. This is the inlet valve and one is the exhaust valve. You can see some fins are surrounding that cylinder. And that fins, that means the maximum area of the cylinder is exposed to the air, and it may be cooled down. So what are the advantages of the air-cooled engine? It is a simpler in design and construction. There is no required the water jacket, radiator, water pump, thermostat, pipes, houses are not needed or not required. And it makes the engine is more compact, isn't it? It makes the engine more compact, and it is comparatively lighter in a weight. Okay. Now, what are the disadvantages of this? This is the uneven cooling of the engine parts. An engine temperature is generally high during the working period. Okay. So next method is the open jacket or hopper method. You can see here, this is the cylinder and this is hopper. It contains the water. There is a hopper or jacket containing water which surrounding the engine cylinder, and engine operate the satisfactorily as long as hopper contains the water. When water start boiling, the hot water is replaced by the cold water, and drain plug is provided in this open jacket method. Now, next is the thermosiphon method. It consists of the radiator, water jacket, fan and temperature gauges and house connection. And this system is based on the principle that heated water which surrounds the cylinder becomes lighter in weight and it rises upward in liquid column. Now hot water goes to the radiator when it passes through the tube surrounded by the air. And circulation of the water take place due to the reason that water jacket and radiator are connected at both sides, at the top and the piston. And a fan is driven with the help of V-belt to suck the air through tubes of the radiator unit or cooling radiator water. And the disadvantage of the system is that circulation of water is greatly reduced by accumulation of the scale or foreign matter in the passage, and consequently it causes the overheating of the engine. Okay. Now for circulation method, in this method water pump is used to feed water from the radiator. You can see in a diagram, this is a radiator cap, this is, you can see the radiator, and here this arrow shows the direction of the air. This is the radiator fan, and this is you can see the thermostat wall. Here it is a thermostat wall, and it is the water jacket surrounding passing through the water. This is the delivery hose. You can see you can see here the hot water come to the top of the radiator, and it may be cooled down and it come to the bottom of the radiator. And again with this fan due to the thermosiphon method, it circulate through the engine cylinder. This is a water pump, and you can see here the hot water, isn't it? And it is a piston, and you can see here it is an engine. And in this method, water pump is used to feed the water from the radiator to the water jacket of the engine. After circulating the entire run of water jacket, water comes back to the radiator. It comes back to the radiator and it loses the heat by the process of the radiation. And to maintain the correct engine temperature, thermostat wall is placed. Here it is placed, the thermostat wall. When the temperature of the engine of water reaches to 81 degrees Celsius to 72 degrees Celsius, that thermostat wall get open and it allow that hot water into the radiator. And that thermostat valve is placed at the outer end of the cylinder head. That cooling liquid is bypassed through the water jacket of the engine until the engine attains the desired temperature. And then thermostat valve open and the bypass is closed. Following the water to go to the radiator, the system of the consist of, first is the water pump, then water jacket, radiator, thermostat wall, fan. The system consists of this part: water pump, water jacket, radiator, thermostat wall, fan, temperature gauge, fan, belt and house pipe. Now the first component is the water pump. It is a centrifugal type of pump. It has a casing and impeller mounted on the shaft. And the casing is usually made up of the cast iron. Pump shaft is made up of the some non-corrosive material at the end of the shaft, and small pulley is fitted, which is driven by V-belt. And water pump is mounted at the end of the cylinder block, between the block and radiator. When the impeller rotates, the water between the impeller blades is thrown outward by the centrifugal force, and thus water goes to the cylinder under the pressure. And the pump outlet is connected by hose pipe to the bottom of the radiator, and the impeller shaft is supported on one or more bearings, and there is a seal which prevents the leakage of the water. So you can see here it is a part of the radiator. A radiator is a device for cooling the circulating water in the engine. It holds the large amount of water in a close contact with a large volume of air so that heat is transferred from water to the air easily. Now, hot water flows into the radiator at the top and cold water flows out from the bottom. The tubes or passengers carry the water from the top of the radiator to the bottom and passing it over large metal surface. Air flows between the tubes or through the sails at right angle to the downward flowing water. This helps in transferring the heat from the water to the atmosphere. On the basis of the fabrication, the radiator is of the two types. One is the tubular type and another is the cellular type. Okay. So now this is about the water cooling system of the tractor. Now another is the air cleaning system of the IC engine. So it needs the air cleaning system. Why it need the air cleaning system? You know, the tractor is a vehicle which is mainly used in the field and mostly under dusty conditions. Therefore, air supply to the tractor engine must be kept free from abrasive material. And unfiltered, the air contains millions of abrasive dust particles, and dust entering the tractor engine is often main cause of the wear. And the dirt collected on the air cleaner increases the resistance to air flow. Okay. And the dirtier air cleaner causes the losses air flow to the engines, and thus engine performance is affected. The partial clogged air cleaner is a common cause of diesel engine smoking. And rapid wear of sleeves, pistons, piston rings, valves, valve guides and valve seat indicate the ineffective air cleaning. The operating efficiency, good performance and durability of an engine mainly depend upon the air cleaner. Hence, it is necessary to filter the air to remove the dirt and abrasive material before admitting to it the engine. So, what are the types of the cleaner? It is a dry type, oil bath type, oil bath type, oil soak element type. So, dry type of air cleaner. These types of air cleaner contain the three main parts. First is the pre-cleaner, main housing, and cleaning element. Okay, these are the sealed into one unit. The main housing contains the cleaning element, usually of multi-wire netting, but some are made up of the nylon or paper. And the air from the atmosphere enter into the pre-cleaner, passes through the cleaning element and goes to the inlet manifold. The paper filter element is cleaned after 50 to 100 hours of service. What are the advantages of the dry type of air cleaner? Easy to service, good performance in gradient and in rough field, more efficient at high speed. And straw and chaff causes the less rejection to the air passage. So what are the disadvantages of the dry type of air cleaner? It is a costlier to maintain than an oil bath because the filter element requires the replacement very often. And sometimes dust particle enter the cylinder. So this is the oil bath type of air cleaner. The main difference in the dry type and oil bath air cleaner is that in the oil bath type, oil is used for cleaning the air. So you can see, dear student, here the pre-cleaner. This is air inlet. You can see the arrow, how the air is come inside that air cleaner. And this is the passage where air is passing through that passage. Okay. Now this is the air tube. You can see here air tube and main element. And it clean the air. And you can see here that is contain the oil cup. It contain the oil. That air come through that passage. You can see the arrow. And then it is passing through the oil. So that dust and other particle get attached with the oil, and air is passing through that oil to the air tube, and clean air get to the engine at the intake valve, to an intake manifold. At the intake manifold, it get the clean air. The oil bath air cleaner You can see the oil bath air cleaner is the most common type of air cleaner used on farm tractors. Dusty air is allowed to pass through an oil bath. A mixture of oil spray and air are carried upward. And the oil is entrapped by the filtering element. That filtering element and drops back while clean air goes to the engine or carburetor. And all fine dust particles which are carried by the air will be washed from the filtering element as the oil drains back to the cup. So, dear student, you will get the idea how clean the air to passing through that oil and filter element. And this is the oil bath air cleaner. You can see, because tractor working under very dusty condition in the field on farm, so it's required. So, due to the constant use, oil cup becomes thicker and thicker and must be replaced by the fresh air after 10 hours of work under normal dusty condition. On job where there is a little or no dust, the oil should only be changed whenever dirt has collected to the depth of 3 to 6 mm in the bottom of the cup. Now, at least once in the year, more often in the dusty condition, the entire air cleaner system should be thoroughly washed, isn't it? It should be remembered that while refilling the oil cup, care should be taken that proper oil level is maintained in the cup. So, what are the tractor always work in dirty condition? You know that. So, in order to prolong the engine life, pre-cleaners are fitted in the upper portion of the main cleaner. When engine is running, the air is drawn through the pre-cleaner to the tube of the main cleaner. Here, large dust particles are removed from the AST and thus reducing much of the load on the main cleaner. The pre-cleaner function of the centrifugal principle by means of the vanes, baffles, it gives the rotary motion to the air, and thus causing the heavier dust particle to throw out due to the centrifugal force and pre-cleaner air passing to the cleaner. And servicing of the air cleaner is important factor in efficient engine performance. And this is, you can see the photographs of the pre-cleaner.